Hello, everybody. My name is Joshua James.
Hello. And I immediately failed, Mr. Bones. I was trying to do a ghost face, and I got it wrong immediately.
Yeah, we're back making a movie review. We are seeing Scream 6. What'd you think of the movie?
Okay, it's great. But there is some,
questions?
No, not questions. There are some things that they bring up from 5.
And other movies.
Or possibly 4.
And past movies,
and
too.
Past movies. But the ones that pop into mind are the things we're going to get into this review.
What did you think of the cast? These are the same cast from...
From 5.
Yeah, so what'd you think?
Okay, I actually like the cast from 5.
Yeah. And now 6?
6? Okay, they're still good, but the add-ins to the group.
The extras?
The kid that's the nerd man. The girl
that sleeps around a lot.
That whores herself out.
And then there's lesbian relationship.
Yes. And then we're just like, okay.
There's no need for you guys.
There's no need to add you guys, but...
We need a kill count.
If we need the death count to go up, so we're in.
But, before we also get to the rest of the cast, I just want to say Jenna Ortega. She is killing it right now in Hollywood right now. She was awesome in Scream 5. She's awesome on Wednesday.
Let's be perfectly clear. I have not seen Scream 5. I had the recap of a certain YouTube recap and show.
Oh, you're going to get a lot of hate.
I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit.
But yeah, Jenna,
bring on the hate. I don't care. Okay, moving on from
Jenna
that.
Jenna Ortega is by far legitimately killing it in Hollywood. I love her act. She's amazing. The rest of the cast is great too, but Jenna Ortega steals it. Because you could definitely tell in this movie, even though her sister had it worse, but you also could definitely tell from Jenna Ortega's character, it's just tired.
She doesn't care. She wants to move on without actually...
Moving on. She's saying like...
She doesn't want to face what happened, but she also wants to go past it.
Yeah, and that's not good to do.
Yeah, as fair point of this movie.
Uh-huh, pretty much, yeah. But the thing is like, this movie is just... It's pretty much also trying to tell you that the internet is bad.
No shit.
What this is also telling you about the movie is, like, the internet, like, a lot of people can spread rumors and all that. They're already making the main character
look like the bad guy.
Because of her father, who's Billy from the first movie.
Which we already knew that from the fifth movie.
So they're making it think, like, she was actually the one that killed people. She's just making her ex-boyfriend, who's actually the killer from the fifth movie, look so innocent, and she just is the one who snapped because who her father is. This movie, great.
It's great.
Violence, but yes.
Death and destruction.
And also, you actually do root for the characters to survive. Because usually...
It's a mixed bag on some horror movies. You got some people that you want to see live. You want to have people you want to see die. And then there's some movies.
Yeah.
I'm looking at you, a Halloween.
Oh my god.
That makes you want everyone in the movie to die.
AKA Halloween Ends.
Exactly. It's like... Oh, why?
I don't know. But in this one, you actually really root for people, except for the first two people. Let's be real here. In the beginning of this movie, there's actually two people that are actually following Richie because he wanted this reboot remake to succeed. So they're trying to go on with this legacy until the actual Ghostface comes in and kills both of them.
Oh, really? You think killing people is easy?
But what about the movie?
Who cares? Who gives a fuck about a movie? Slash.
Oh, that was...
Just murders the guy and his accomplice in the fridge.
Yeah. This movie is legitimately bloody. It is bloody.
It does not skimp leg day on fucking blood and gore.
Especially Ghostface, because that guy never got tired.
We're not going to spoil
Ghostface this, because that will be cheating. And
they'll be cheating. You watch the movie yourself.
Go see the movie. Yeah, definitely, because this is a movie that you need to see. Because here's the thing: if you're getting tired of seeing the Scream movies, I'm gonna be honest. I got tired of it because I was like, why do they need to make another movie? There's no
point. Because they're trying to reboot a movie that doesn't exist in real life.
But the thing is, even though I'm still gonna go see it, after when you see it, you're just like, I regret talking crap about this movie. This movie was great. Because so far, I think the only one that a lot of people did not care for, which I don't get why, is Scream 3. Scream 3 gets a lot of hate. And I don't get why.
I was about to say, let's recap all the movie endings, shall we?
Or can we go... Well, they're going back to normal numbers and names in movies now, like Scriform. And Scream 5, which is called...
I hate that name, but he keeps wanting it to exist because how they spelt it.
No, it was actually just called,
Scrimfor.
Yeah, that's what was on the poster. And,
Scrimfor.
And the fifth movie was just called Scream. It should have been Five Cream, like what Jeremy Johns said in his movie reviews.
No. Yes, but no.
Instead of the S, it should have just been a 5. That's what they should have done. I agree with Jeremy Johns on his review that it should be called Five Cream instead of Scream 5.
Because that could be interpreted in many different ways.
It still would be.
And all of them are dirty.
Do you expect something like that from a Scream? Look what movie we're talking about.
It is Scream. Indeed, it's Scream 6.
Yeah.
But it's classy in its terribleness. Let's be real here. It's still terrible.
What did you think of Ghostface in the mask? The old, beat-up, crusty mask that he is wearing.
I actually liked it.
It reminded me of Michael Myers' mask, because not just in the recent one that we saw, but also in the Rob Zombie Halloween movies that you never saw. He always wears a beat up crusty mask.
I still want to see this, by the way.
Alright, and the next time you come over, we'll watch him.
But
anyways,
I want to see what the people call the bane of all Halloween existence.
Or you'll get my side. A lot of people actually think this movie was good because it's different.
It is what he says is different. I call ingenuity.
You're in the middle.
Yeah, I call it straight down the middle. It's ingenuity.
But anyways,
they had what they had, and they gave us what they gave us.
What did you think of the Ghostface mask?
Okay, I liked it. I like the many masks that they
from the past movies
that they showed.
Yeah, from the past movies. So, what did you think of the killings?
Okay, they were good.
Did you have a favorite kill?
Okay, I did have a favorite kill, and that was the stab in the face.
Okay, so you like
just
that one.
Wham!
Okay.
Like it wasn't like on the nose, but it was right beside it. It was amazing.
Mine is the first kill. That's my favorite one so far. There's not a lot of kills in this movie, but the first one was my favorite one. Because it had to do with the douchebags who were trying to follow Richie's dream to finish the movie.
They finished a movie, their movie of their lives.
But also the thing is like the whole cast was great. There is a love interests in this movie that you actually kind of care about, but also
it comes out of left field.
Randomly, just out of nowhere.
Like, it's just the, like, I'm here. I'm here now.
Pretty much.
Like, I was here off screen. I'm here now.
But also, I like the fact they're in New York City, which, by the way, they could have found a better place than New York City because that you call that place safe? No. That place is.
Hey, they were going to college.
You couldn't have picked it any other place.
True.
But anyways, it's like it was a cool setup because they were in New York City or New York, I'm just gonna say. It's because it was a different,
A different place,
different areas.
different everything.
Also, you could tell that there was a bigger budget because they were allowed to do stuff like that. Jason takes my hand and take notes.
We did not talk about that movie.
And we're gonna
Because that movie had nothing to do with anything. All
no.
right, all right.
Anyways, but this movie, I give it a solid. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do this. I give it 5 stars.
You're going to give it a perfect.
Yes, because I actually. Here's the thing. I actually really did think this movie was great. The only thing I did not like is the after credits scene because our buddy Brandon told us there was an after credits scene. Didn't we?
Because like you told me not to tell
We
anybody.
Told him not
I
to
know.
spoil
No,
it.
the thing is, I'm not mad at you. I'm mad at the movie for
for
that.
being a piece of
Yeah,
shit.
I'm not mad at you. It's just the like I was expecting like maybe see like Shaggy come back for like if there is ever gonna be a sequel because it's rumored that he's still alive. So I was expecting maybe like an after credit scene, but no, it shouldn't have been there.
Okay, do we spoil it though? Or do we just let them
You check.
watch
You
it?
watch it. You already know my
You
thoughts on it. You watch it.
have to wait through the entire credit scene. The entire credits. Which
But I still didn't like the
at
movie.
the end, it's funny. I'm not spoiling the end video, which had nothing to do with anything.
Yeah.
I'm spoiling the little image at the bottom before it cuts to it. It's the ghost face killer about to kill someone. The
And
logo.
yeah,
The ghost face logo.
I like that. But I give it 5 stars because I actually really do enjoy it. And here's the thing. Yeah, I was talking crap about the after credits scene, but that's not gonna take away from this movie being good.
I
Here's the
mean,
thing, it's a lot better than Halloween Ends, I can tell you that.
were they rushed it?
Yeah, it was completely rushed for Halloween Ends. And here's the thing, I liked but also did not like Halloween Ends. This one I actually really
Wait,
didn't.
I was meh.
I was meh too. But this one I liked a lot better. This one was way better. Like if this was gonna be the final Scream movie, it was a good way to end it. But do I think it's gonna be the last one? No. This
Okay.
is Hollywood we're talking about.
Okay, I'm going to change the ratings for mine.
Okay.
I give it a 98 out of 100. It's almost a perfect movie. It's hard to get it right.
So 4.5 stars.
Four and a half stars.
Okay.
Because there is possibly one scene that basically I was like, why? What makes you think this is a good idea to escape?
Oh, I think I know what you're talking about.
Yeah,
I think I know what you're talking about.
basically,
But
yeah,
so
he knows my stance on that scene, and he also had this thing going, move faster! What are you
yeah. Okay,
doing?
so 5 stars for me, 4.5 for you.
Yeah,
All right.
it was a perfect movie.
But is it perfect compared to Halloween Ends?
No, I can't say anything because I know a few movies that are way worse than Halloween Ends. I'm looking at you.
Halloween 6.
Halloween 6, I'm looking at you.
Yeah, that's the I hate that one too.
so
But yeah, that's our review. Again, if you were expecting us to spoil anything, we're not doing that. We will spoil. If you want us to do a spoiler review, we will do
it. We will have it written, spoilers! And then we just go at her.
But the thing is like, I like Scream. Again, will this be the last one?
No! Fuck no! You want to know why?
Hollywood. That's why.
They're going to beat the series until it's dead, and then beat it some more.
I mean, look at Hollywood right now. We're getting another Toy Story movie. And another Cars movie. Do we need that? No, we don't.
For the kids, but even then, it's like, when is enough enough?
I'm still waiting for, like, Jason and Freddy to come back.
Freddy versus Jason?
I would love to see another one.
The two and eight?
I would love to see that, but I know we'll never get that. But anyways, thank you guys for watching. My name is Joshua James.
And I am Mr. Bones.
And thank you guys for watching our review. We'll see you guys next time. We will be back. I know I took a long break, but hey, burnout's a real thing.
You have to
You have no excuse.
He has to take a break. My excuse is,
you're lazy.
That, and sometimes I get burned out from watching all the videos. from watching all the it's not that I get burned out, it's more like emotionally drained from watching fucking Dark Side of the Ring. God damn.
But we will be back doing more reviews. Actually, speaking of reviews, spring is almost here. And
you mean that it is here?
Not yet. It's not bright and sunny out yet.
Bitch! We're not in school!
When I say spring, I'm talking I'm talking about the daylight timing stuff. That's when spring officially starts for me.
It starts the moment it hits March.
But it's not spring.
But it is spring.
But anyways, what we're doing...
It is the month of spring, which makes it spring. Fuck off.
But what we're doing for spring, which will be Sunday, we're going to be reviewing some more movies. Movies that you have not seen. We're going to be...
I haven't?
You've never seen these movies. You've only seen reviews for them.
What are the movies?
We're going to be watching the Mortal Kombat movies.
Oh, Jesus.
We're going to be watching them from The Journey Begins to the current one.
So the shitty animated one?
Yes.
To the one that...
was the 1995 one, which was good, to Annihilation, which was an abomination. Hey, that's right.
I was about to say, you better not say anything good about that piece of shit.
But hey, I made a rhyme. And then...
Oh, okay.
And then the... 2021 Mortal Kombat movie.
Oh yeah, I forgot that was even a thing.
So we're gonna
because
be reviewing those.
It was one of those years. It was the year after the year that shit got fucked.
Yeah.
And then at 21 wasn't much better. So it's just a blur for me.
So we're going to be watching the Mortal Kombat movies. That is coming up soon. That's going to be one I'm actually really looking forward to reviewing. So you can finally get to see what A Journey Begins is. I'm looking forward to that one the most out of all of them.
I kind of seen like a little tad bits of fucking...
Not the whole thing.
No. Annihilation.
That one I am looking forward to the
which
most
was
also.
Which was terrible.
I am looking forward to you seeing the bad. Legitimately the bad.
That's his job here, is to educate me on how shitty movies are.
Again,
and can be.
Thank you guys for watching.
I'm looking at you, Halloween 6. I'm looking at you.
I agree with you on Halloween 6, though. But also Resurrection 2.
Fucking
Busta Rhymes.
Where Busta Rhymes wins against Michael Myers. What the? Who wrote this?
the people who made it.
That excuses no one.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. But again, thank you guys for watching. My name is Joshua James.
And I'm going to sit somewhere and sulk.
Alright guys, we love you so much. See you next time. Bye-bye.